Hello everyone. So now next our session is about, I'm just giving this continuation of the earlier session that was backpropagation network 1 and this is backpropagation network 2. This is the continuation of layer computation. We have already done the input layer computation. That means we have calculated the output at the input layer. Then we have calculated the hidden layer input and the output of the hidden layer. Now the third computation is left, that is the output layer computation. What we have to calculate at the output layer, we have to calculate the input at the output layer and the output at the output layer. After that, we are going to calculate the error, which is a most important part of the network. Now, for output layer computation, we are just going to understand this diagram. What was it? This was the earlier diagram in which we have, this is the hidden layer. This is just a part of that starting diagram in which we have taken only the consideration of hidden layer and the output layer. Output layer ka bhi humne sirf ek neuron liya hai. We have considered the kth neuron. Okay, kth node. Why only kth node? Because we are going to show the computation which is to be defined, and we are considering and we are going to give the computation calculation over one node, and it will be same for all the nodes in the output layer. So what we have to do is, this is the hidden layer. Just a review back, this is the hidden layer. So this is called as the input of hidden layer at the first node. This is, then this is OH1, that is called as the output at the hidden layer of the first node. This link is called as the link between the hidden layer and the output layer. This is OOQ. Why OOQ? This is output of output layer at the qth neuron. And here it will be the input of the output layer at the qth neuron. And this link shows the weight between the hidden layer and the output layer, which will be defined with the help of WI1Q, W2Q, W3Q till WOQ. Now what this this is considered as first input, this is hidden layer. Hidden layer ke first node se connected hai ye output layer ke qth node se. So that is why W1Q. Then this particular is connected from second node of hidden layer to the qth node of the output layer. So that is W2Q and so on and so forth. Right, this is the bias weight which I have already discussed. That is, input layer is still, hidden layer is of mth neurons, m neurons hai yahan pe. So, this is the bias weight we have added, which is minus 1. And here, I am defining it as the threshold, that is the theta. Okay, so now understanding this, when I have to calculate the input at the output layer, so what will be the calculation? The calculation will be the OH1 multiplied by the W1Q. And this net weighted sum will be calculated. So this is what is shown here. Now the input to the input layer neurons, output layer neurons is the weighted sum of the output of the hidden neurons. Okay, because hamare output layer ke liye input kya hai? The output of the hidden neurons and the weights. So the IOQ, I already told you why I'm considering Q. I'm considering any qth neuron. Now Q will lie from 1 to n. Why 1 to n? Because I have n number of nodes in the output layer. So this is IOQ will be equal to W1Q multiplied by OH1 plus W2Q multiplied by OH2 plus W3Q multiplied by OH3. This will go on plus till WMQ OHM. YM, because hidden layer mein kitne number of nodes hai? M number of nodes hai. So that is why it is M. Now I have just calculated it in the matrix form. That is the input of the output layer will be equal to, this is what I was calculating. I was calculating the output layer input will be equal to transpose of W, that is the weight matrix, and the out will be multiplied by the output of the hidden layer. So this is the generalized matrix I get as the input calculation. Now moving further, I have to now calculate the output at the output layer. Again, I'll consider a qubit neuron same way, and I'm going to calculate the output at the output layer. Now, again, I'm going to calculate it with the help of a sigmoidal function. I'm considering sigmoidal function. Sigmoidal function ka formula kya tha? That was 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus e raised to the power lambda I. Now, lambda I ko we have because compared it with this. So that is why IOQ minus theta OQ, where theta is what? Theta is the threshold of the QH neuron. So these are the notations. OOQ is the output of the QH output neuron. IOQ is the input of the QH output neuron. And theta OQ is the threshold of the QH neuron. Now again, they are considering the OH neuron in the hidden layer with output of minus 1. That is what we are doing here. We have considered one more hidden layer neuron, that is the O neuron, which is a kind of bias and threshold value. Now this treating threshold in the input layer will give you the output as generalized output. The output at the output layer, see OO, YOO, output at the O output layer. Now I'm not only going to give it as Q. Why only Q? Because ye puri matrix ka define karta hai, and I'm just showing the calculation of the QH neuron. This particular will be 1, 2, 3 till nth neuron. Okay, and somewhere in between lies the qth neuron node. So this is 1 divided by 1 plus e raised to power minus lambda. I ki jagah humne kya place kiya hai? Again, IOQ minus theta OQ. So this is the computation of output layer. That means we have calculated the input of the output layer and the output of the output layer. Now, we need to, once we get the final output, we need to calculate the error. Why we need to calculate the error? We are going to calculate the error, that is, if there is the error can be calculated as the comparison between the target output and the actual output. Whatever the difference is there, that will be calculated as an error. And again, we are going to adjust the weight for calculating the output again. So if we consider any rth output, same way mein humne yahan pe rth output neuron consider kiya hai, koi bhi jahan pe hum error calculate kar rahe hain. For training example, we have calculated the output O, for which target output is T. So humne kaha ki O kya hai? O is denoted as the actual output, and T is denoted as the target output. We can also say actual output or calculated output, and this one is at the target output. Then the error norm in output for the rth output neuron will be what? Er dash is equal to half, that is 1 by 2 er square. Now this is represented as 1 by t minus o square. Why? Because e is what? E is the difference between the target output and the actual output. So e is equal to t minus o. That is what we have kept it out here. Now er ka first second form norm jo hoga error ka in the rth neuron considering is considered irrespective of negative or positive. We are not going to consider whether the error is negative or positive. The Euclidean norm hum calculate karenge first training pattern ke liye, that will be e dash is equal to half and summation of what? TOR, YOR, because we are considering at the rth neuron output layer ke rth neuron pe target output kya hai माइनस आउटपुट लेयर के आरएथ न्यूरॉन पे आउटपुट क्या है एंड द डिफरेंस द होल स्क्वायर एंड आर विल बी व्हाट आर इज 1 टू एन व्हाई आर इज 1 टू एन आर इज 1 टू एन बिकॉज़ वी हैव एनथ नंबर ऑफ नोड्स इन द आउटपुट लेयर सो दिस इज व्हाट वी गेट नाउ अबव इक्वेशन को हम एक फंक्शनल फॉर्म में रखेंगे ट्रेनिंग पैटर्न में इफ सेम टेक्निक इज यूज्ड फॉर ऑल वी गेट व्हाट ईवीडब्ल्यू व्हाट इज दिस वीडब्ल्यू वी इज द weight synapse which is connecting the input layer to the hidden layer earlier architecture agar aap yaad karoge to and w is what w is the hidden layer and output layer connection of synapse so that will be equal to j 1 to n set jo bhi humne n set of parameters use kiye hain e v w I v w I where e is the error function so this is how we are going to calculate the error so in back propagation network what we have calculated we have taken the input at the input layer and given and calculated the output at the input layer then we have calculated the input of the hidden layer and then we have calculated the output of the hidden layer Then we come to output layer. We have calculated the input of output layer, and we have calculated the output of output layer. And lastly, we have calculated the error for our training set of pattern. So that's all for today. And in the next lecture, we are going to do the backpropagation algorithm, which is very important. So thank you, everyone.